Okay, we're at Modesto, and we've shut down, and we're going to take a short break here, hit the restroom, get a cup of coffee, and wait for the fuel truck to arrive. So you'll see, by the time we get through with all that, get fueled up, ready to go again, it's now daylight. So it was getting that way when we landed. See the instrument panel without the lights and so on and so forth. So anyhow, we're fired back up here and we're going to pretty nice skies, not too much overcast, not too much clouds. Don't know why I scanned down here, but I was playing with the controls in the flight simulator, that is. Anyhow, we're gonna proceed to taxi off here, and we got the thing, all engine all turned up, instruments checked, little quickie brief pre-flight again, and I know this is long and drawn out here, but anyhow, soon we will be moving. I guess we're waiting for the fuel truck. That's what we're waiting for. We're waiting actually we can't, because we're running. Anyhow, don't know what we're waiting for. Clearance, I don't know. Anyhow, I'll shut up here in just a few minutes and we'll see that we start taxiing back out. Sorry for the long, drawn-out, boring section we've got going here. Well, I think what I'm doing is, yeah, here, I'm setting the altimeter. Altimeter set up to match Modesto. I was setting it with the barometric pressure, which, if you followed the barometric pressure, it said it was minus 200 feet, but actually I was reading it wrong. It's hard to see for you on the screen, but I can see it. And not exactly sure without looking it up what the altitude's supposed to be, but I'm assuming I got it right here. Must have. I was happy with it. Done with that. And now we're starting our rollout. And we'll get back out on the runway and head out for the Bay Area. See, the sun's now up, so you'll be able to see, and I'll be using a different text highlight here when I do different point out different things as I go along. Won't be doing too much voiceover. What we do is we fly west till we hit I-5, then we go north, connect with, I think it's the 205 or whatever it is, maybe, I'm not sure. Whether it's 205 or 580 or whatever it is, but anyhow, I think it's 580. And then we connect with that, go up over Altamont Pass, over Pleasanton, San Ramon, until we get to about just a little north of San Leandro, and turn north, follow the east side of the bay up, and cross over right over the Golden Gate or Oakland Bay Bridge, swing along the Fisherman's Wharf, round by the Presidio, do a little exciting dive under the Golden Gate Bridge, which sadly doesn't look anything like the real Golden Gate Bridge, which is a pretty impressive, pretty bridge. But in the simulator here, it makes it a pretty boring, not realistic bridge. But we fly under it, and you say, why? Why not? It's there, something you can do on a simulator safely. You can't do in real life. Not if you're being responsible. Anyhow, we'll be checking the map from time to time. There is one instance when I'll probably cut out of here where I accidentally touched the plane while I was looking at the map, and that causes the simulator to say, oh, you can't do that, illegal, and drops it on the ground, and we have to take off. But I'll probably cut that out. May or may not. You just have to wait and see. we're taxiing up to the end of the runway here. And then we'll do a... I don't know, I did a mag check again here. I probably did if I was being responsible. And pre-rotate and take off. Winds are calm right now. That's why I can pick either direction to take off in. Yeah, we're on 10 right runway, which is the shorter of the two runways at Modesto. Better for us small guys, since we're not fighting with jet traffic on the other runway. So, yeah, looks like we're checking mags here. And we're getting ready to pre-rotate. Yeah, here we go, we're pre-rotating. 100 RPM. Doesn't want to go higher than that, so we're just going to accelerate and pick up the other 100 RPM to gently accelerate. There we go, we're lifted off. Alright, I'll be quiet for now, and then we're banking off. We'll do a midfield crossover on the 10 left and hit almost due west. The coast. So I'll be quiet. Talk to you soon. If you haven't noticed here, I've been slowly picking up altitude too, which I'm going to need to clear Altamont Pass. And just checking the map here. I don't know whether this is a situation where I... Nope, that was one of the good map checks. I didn't touch the airplane. There's a little quirk it's actually a no-cheat factor that's built into the X-Plane simulator, that if you grab the airplane on a map and move it, it says that's cheating and immediately will cause you to lose all rotor RPM, which immediately causes you to lose all flight, as is the evidence right here. And bingo, down you go. And we're crashed. This is not a real crash, didn't really happen. But it puts you at the nearest little airport, which I don't remember which one this was, but it's right off of I-5, just south of Tracy. And then you have to go through the routine of getting back in the air and flying all over again. So, a little inconvenience. I left it in here. I was going to cut it out because it's kind of a screw up like that. But anyhow, pre-rotate, which I'm doing right here, get the airspeed back up, because that's what it does, it kills your rotor. Anyhow, looks like we're about ready to hit it. Yep, off and running again. If you're really interested, I'll let me know in the footnotes and I'll look up where the airport this was, but it's kind of academic since it was really not part of the planned flight, just an oops when you're observing the map. So, anyhow, quiet down here. We're coming up on the turn to the west that takes us up. Well, you get to see us flying up over Altamont Pass. Unfortunately, the simulator doesn't show the multitude of windmills that are there along Altamont Pass, which is pretty impressive. It must generate quite a bit of power, although I've always wondered why we don't see. I took off to the south here, obviously. There's the sun, so I'm having to turn around. There's I-5 again. We're going to line up going north with I-5. Anyhow, what I started to say was that I was always amazed that you don't see all those windmills running. It seems like there's only like 10-20% of them running at the time you go by. I don't know whether it's... Why not generate more power that way? So, save on the power generation. Although I think California's pretty well... Again, I don't know this for a fact. I think California's pretty well shut down all of the nuclear plants because of earthquake. That little glitch you just saw there when I jerked the wheel or the stick to the left, but the screen rolled up, is that the little button that turns the GPS on, which is in the center of the screen, it hides behind the stick. You can't get to it with the cursor to turn it on, so you have to do a little tweak movement there, pull the stick over, click on it real quick, put it back so you don't lose too much altitude or go into a real hard bank left turn. So anyhow, be quiet here. Well, yeah, we're coming up on Tracy here in just a couple minutes, I guess. See you soon. just clearing the mountains here, the little coastal range, and coming up on 880 Expressway, which is just probably intersecting it just north of San Leandro. And we'll follow that north until we get to Oakland and the Oakland Bay Bridge. Cut across the bay right there towards downtown San Francisco, following the Bay Bridge just a little bit on the north side, so we'll go right over Treasure Island, which used to be a big Navy base, may still be, I'm not sure what's out there now. Anyhow, then we'll skirt around the east shore of San Francisco, downtown San Francisco, over Fisherman's Wharf and around up by the Presidio. And then you can sit back and watch us do the stupid tricks, video only, simulator only, not to be done in real life. Fly under the Golden Gate Bridge and circle around and head up over the pass, not the pass, but the mountains to San Rafel. Throw some more music in here. Maybe I can find something appropriate that's royalty-free from YouTube. Okay, this is the hard part. I have never been to the San Rafel airport before, especially from the air. I did live in San Rafel way back in early 1970. Lived in Corte Madera and San Rafel for the year 70 to mid 71, somewhere in there. Anyhow, you'll see that I circle around and around, keep checking the map, and airport should be pretty easy to spot. And I was close, but it wasn't until I ended up landing on a road and shutting everything down and going back and actually having to use Google Maps to find it that I was able to locate the runway. But once I found it, it's pretty obvious once you know that it's on the north side of that little inlet instead of the south side, which I was circling around and around. You know, it's pretty easy to find. So anyhow, kind of coming in here, I'll shut up. And you can see where we spend a lot of time here looking and looking and looking and not finding it, even flying a low altitude. Maybe I should have went up a little higher, because a lot of times you can see better from a height. Been advised to do that on several occasions where if you can't see it, get up in the air to where you can get a better overall view, especially in the simulator, because you only have a straight ahead view, and in real life you can look left and right. You could probably would have spotted it right off if I'd have been in a real gyro. Anyhow, I'll shut up and throw some more music in here until we land, and then we'll wrap this thing up. I know it's been long. If you've stuck here this long, you really must be bored and not have anything else to do. This is one of the first YouTubes that I think of. I think it's going to come out probably an hour and a half. That's what it says it's going to come out to. An hour and 36 minutes, actually. I thought it was going to be closer to two based on this audio file, but according to my screen here, my editing screen, I'm at an hour and 36 minutes and 37 seconds. So anyhow, here's where we start looking for the airport. And the problem is, as I explained, is we're on the south side of this little inlet. The airport's on the north side of the little inlet water here. In other words, if I were to cut to my right here by 90 degrees, I'd probably fly right over it. But I don't do that. I keep looking around here thinking, from the little GPS map, which is not very high res, in the middle of the dash, that I'm right over it, and it shows me right over it, but in fact it's off, like all GPSs can be off. Never trust the GPS, trust your eyes.
Beast.
Okay, we're still looking. As you know, we got close, but I'm about to give up here and stop, get out my trusty iPhone and look it up on the Google Maps. When in doubt, look at the phone. But you shouldn't do that while you're flying, especially at this low altitude. So, anyhow, see if I can't find some more music that's royalty-free from YouTube that I haven't used yet. And we'll pick up. You'll see that we finally do get there with the help of Google Maps, my iPhone, etc.
9:45. That's all, folks.